Godzilla! It's over! You must forgive! Damn lizard!
We interrupt this program to give you a bulletin just received from one of our naval units at sea. A large object traveling at supersonic speed is headed over the North Atlantic toward the east coast of the United States.
An unidentified object was picked up 200 miles southwest of Point Barrow, Alaska.
Shall we report it, sir?
What, that we're being invaded by little green men from outer space?
Flying saucers have invaded our planet.
It was a saucer. A flying saucer.
According to evidence, these creatures have scientific knowledge far in advance of our own.
We've come to this planet looking for intelligent life. Oops, we made a mistake.
Welcome yet again to the podcast that showcases humans behaving badly. This is why the aliens don't come. My name is Brendan Millett, and with me is the celebrated Michelle Poitras.
Celebrated? Wow. I'm like Twitter famous?
Yes, totally Twitter famous.
Twitter famous.
I was Twitter famous, actually, I don't know, about a week ago?
Yeah, you were telling me.
Yeah, for those of you who don't know, Kevin Smith is a co-host of a podcast called Hollywood Babylon that I absolutely love.
If you have to explain it, you're not Twitter famous.
Exactly. And I tweeted something to his co-host, Ralph Garman, and he favorited it. And I'm about as obsessed with that show as Michelle is with her beloved Fall Out Boy, but I don't want to fuck them.
Kevin Smith actually favorited a tweet of mine, though. The Kevin Smith.
What was it?
Because it was yet another snowstorm.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, what's your encore, Winter? Do you anally rape my mother while pouring sugar in my gas tank?
Nice Clerks reference.
And Kevin Smith favorited it.
Nice. I was fishing for him to favorite a tweet of mine at one point.
Yeah.
Like, he posted something absolutely ridiculous. I don't remember what it was, and I just posted, go home, Kevin, you're baked.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, he's a hardcore stoner.
Yes, he is.
They used to do a bit on that show called What Strain Is Kevin On? But they haven't done it. And it was almost always Skywalker OG or Girl Scout cookies.
There are strains?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Why
would I know that?
I had one called Charlie Sheen once.
Oh, Lord.
I was winning.
I say, are you full of Tiger Blood and winning?
I felt like it. But yeah, when the guy said, oh, yeah, this is called Charlie Sheen, I went, oh, shit.
And you're like,
I almost don't want to smoke this.
You're like, no, I have to try. Don't reenact scenes from Platoon with Charlie Sheen.
I had to try it for science.
For science.
For science.
Of course.
Yes, I was a stoner lab rat.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And we wonder why the aliens don't come.
Yeah, because they're like, oh, yeah.
Because tiger blood and winning.
And the Millet kids baked. Yeah. Anyway, folks, thank you for joining us. If it's your first time, welcome. Please join our Facebook group and also find us on YouTube, SoundCloud, and on Twitter at
TIWTADC.
You know, it took me the longest time to get that right.
Because
there's way too many initials.
I made it up, and I still had a hard time.
I know,
time
but just
right.
Like that succession of initials. It was just like, I'm like, TW. Fuck, I don't even know.
TWA, I don't know.
Yeah. TMI, I don't even know. But yeah, after hearing you say it enough, I finally got it. Yeah. So.
It's weird. I had to make it into a word. So mm-hmm. I call it tutatic.
No.
That was the only way I could keep it straight so I could spell it out.
Tutatic. That better not become a fucking thing.
I don't know.
I will be so, so unsettled.
We're going to start making up like a word of the day.
Today's secret word is tutatic. Tutatical. Anyway.
There you go.
Tutatical, tatical.
Okay.
That was a really bad Ninja Turtles reference.
Yeah,
I apologize. I'll put the crickets over that, I think.
That was bad.
But if you're new to the podcast, we do several segments on this show, usually a rotating cast of them, but there's one that we like to do each and every week called Headlines.
I said the headlines. Headlines. Have you heard it? Headlines. Headlines. Hit it.
That whole bit we did with the, like, we were doing the bluesy version, and I'm like, tell it, testify.
Testify.
It was fucking hysterical.
Headlines, have you heard it? Tell it on the mountain with headlines.
We're doing it again. We're rehashing old jokes from like 2 weeks ago.
So?
But for those of you who don't know.
Should we rehash old obituaries from 2 weeks ago? I mean.
No, I don't think I want to do an obituary segment. There's nothing really funny about that. But there are headlines that are funny.
Yes.
And sometimes unintentionally.
And sometimes there are obituary headlines.
Have we ever had an obituary
headline? I think we've had a couple that was like, someone died by this or whatever.
Yeah.
Sorta.
Right, right, right. But not an actual obituary, I don't think. But usually it's headlines that are not very carefully worded and carry a double meaning.
Or perhaps a little too carefully worded.
Yes, that could be. Or just the juxtaposition with something else, you know, makes it funny. Like, we've had a couple of those. But this week, what the fuck?
Okay.
Seriously. Like this first one. Federal judge bench slaps litigant for acting like an ostrich. Please explain to me what that means. How exactly do you act like an ostrich? They don't really have any distinguishing characteristics except being a big flightless bird.
They run really fast, they kick really hard, and they bury their heads in the sand.
Nothing you want to do in court.
No.
Definitely not.
Did he poop on the bench like a bird? That would actually be kind of awesome.
That would not help your case.
No, it would not help your case, but would be a legendary story to tell your friends.
That would be.
then I pooped on the bench. I was held in contempt.
Oh, that would have been a pretty good story for our old accidental poop segment, but that would have been on purpose poop.
That's on purpose, yeah. You can't call that accidental.
No, definitely not.
No.
But yes, acting like an ostrich.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
There's the ostrich syndrome. Which if you don't see it, if it isn't there.
So maybe this person was just acting like they didn't see something or hear something or whatever. Just
like,
totally
la, 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 never happened, la, la, la. I don't know.
I've never seen an ostrich go la, la, la.
No, no, but
they don't have anything to stick in their non-existent ears.
No, but that's what we do when we're
right.
Doing the, I don't see it, I don't hear it, doesn't exist. La, 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 can't hear you, la, la, la. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, very mature litigant, obviously.
Yeah, I guess so. This one. I didn't even know this was a thing.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm a little disturbed
okay.
by this. Skydiver lands on beer vendor at women's coleslaw wrestling event. Now, I've heard of mud wrestling.
I have seen the top of the mountain, and it is good.
I have heard of jello wrestling. Never heard anything about women in wrestling and no coleslaw. That's got a... Ooh, you don't want that getting places.
No, probably not.
No.
No, probably not.
You almost don't want to ever have food anywhere in your bits.
You're not the one who got mayonnaise in your cooch.
I would not go see a band called Mayonnaise Cooch. Definitely not.
No, definitely not.
But I did. Have you ever heard of this coleslaw wrestling thing?
Never.
Really?
No, I have not. In all of my trolling of the fanfiction universe, I have never heard of coleslaw wrestling. I've seen some fucked up shit. I've never seen coleslaw wrestling.
You're going to incorporate it now, aren't
no,
you?
No, I am
now,
not.
Brace yourself. Coleslaw wrestling is coming.
No, no, no. That is not happening.
That's just... First of all, I hate coleslaw, so...
I love coleslaw.
Oh, God, it's so disgusting.
I love it.
Oh, anytime I go to a seafood place and they bring me, like, the fish and chips or the fried clams and they give me the coleslaw, I'm like, take it back.
See, I don't like restaurant coleslaw. I like homemade coleslaw.
I've had both. I tried homemade coleslaw because somebody was telling me, you know, even if you don't like coleslaw, you like this. Nope. Still tasted like a bucket of yuck.
Well, I'm sorry you're wrong. I'm sorry that, like, I don't know what childhood trauma befell you
mm-hmm.
that makes you not like anything that's delicious.
Now, see, I would go see a band called Coleslaw Trauma.
Coleslaw Trauma is a good one. That is a good one.
If I was doing this podcast alone, would I still be wrong?
Probably.
Yeah, and there's no Michelle around to hear me.
No, because I'd call in and be like, you're wrong. I would call you on your phone and be like...
How do you do this podcast being full of such wrongness?
Exactly. Like, I'm sorry, you're wrong. You... No, 180 that, because you're the opposite of right. Right now. Right now. Turn this car around.
This one is big. Just a big, big defuck.
Okay.
Virgin holds off 10,000 in Peachtree.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm like, are there 10,000 guys trying to get at her while she's in a peach tree?
I don't know. Is Peachtree the name of like a town?
Maybe, but it wasn't capitalized.
And Peachtree.
Okay, I mean, there's I see the metaphor of virgin and peach.
No, no.
But I don't
really
think
don't...
that's where they were going.
Mm-mm.
But 10,000?
10,000.
This chick must be hot!
Well, that you don't know that that's
if
all
there. 10,000 guys were trying to get at her.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it would seem like... I'm saying, like, you don't even know what she was holding off the 10,000 people from.
Or with.
Or with.
Was she just pelting them with peaches?
Virgin. Maybe they mean, like, Virgin Mobile? Like, the company holds off 10,000?
In a peach tree?
I don't know.
The peach tree part doesn't work with that.
I don't know. Maybe peach tree is the name of some system. I have no idea.
I mean, is she just beating them with a stick going, no, no, get away. One time, one at a time. You know, or something like that.
I don't know.
I don't know.
That is a weird headline. I need more information to make a decision.
If somebody wants to research that one, definitely private message one of us.
Or just tweet one of us.
Or tweet us.
Tweet us. Let us know, please. Like, yeah. Solve this mystery. It might keep me awake at night. I doubt it, but it might.
Oh, but the coleslaw wrestling won't. That one's going to keep me awake.
No, because I know exactly what that is. There's no mystery to that. Mystery and intrigue is what's...
I should have introduced you as the mysterious Michelle Poitras.
I am the least mysterious person in the history of the universe.
Oh, that is so not true. I've known you 20 years and there's still shit I don't get about you.
But it's not stuff you don't know.
That's true.
I'm not mysterious. I might be confusing. I'm not mysterious.
Fuck yes.
I'm a very uncomplicated person.
I don't know about that either, but whatever. This one's just kind of, you know, like mm-hmm. that. It's kind of obvious. Mm-hmm. Stiff opposition expected to casketless funeral plan. Stiff opposition.
Yeah. Has anyone made the stiffy joke? Yes, Rick did.
Why would you have a casketless funeral plan?
I don't know.
They just chuck you in the ground? Wait, that wasn't funny. What are you laughing at?
You get the ankles and I'll get the wrists. One, two, three.
Not even in a cardboard box, something, you know? Was that a reference to something I don't get? Because it didn't seem like it was that funny.
Well, you get the ankles and I'll get the wrists. It's a soul coughing lyric.
Oh.
But then I just actually had the image of two people, like, just
one,
holding the two, three, and just chucking them in the ground. Just like, my grandmother actually said that. She said she didn't want a big, like, funeral or mm-hmm. wake or anything like that. She's like, just throw me in the ground.
Well, I told you what I want when I go. I don't want a wake. I don't want, like, somber anything. I want to have a roast. I want just, like, put a picture of me up and make fun of me. And if
Lord knows you are screaming out for it.
Oh yeah, if I kicked now, you've got enough material.
Oh my god, and
you
know,
imagine 30, 40 years from now?
I would be your would be roastmaster. Yes.
Hell yes, you would.
Oh yes. I know more shit about you than your mama.
Yeah, some of it I don't know if I want made public, but I'll be dead, so I won't care.
You'll be dead, so who cares?
Yeah.
Exactly.
You'll pull something like frickin' mm-hmm. what's his name? John Cleese pulled a Graham Chapman's funeral, and I'm glad the bastard's dead. mm-hmm. This is another cute one, kind of like that.
Okay.
Two convicts evade noose, jury hung.
Oh, yeah. Well, now we know where the noose went. Mm-hmm. They evaded the noose, and now the jury's hung, so.
Wow, that's the first time you got crickets.
It's true.
Does that make it a mom joke?
Kinda. A total stranger online called me mom. I got the mom thing.
And not in a kinky way, I
imagine. No.
Just that stupid fucking mom-dad Twitter
shit. Yeah, the mom-dad Twitter thing, but yeah.
That needs to stop. Seriously.
Yeah, it's like, oh, you're my mom now. Like, no, I would be a terrible mother. I think that's a really poor life choice on your part.
Pick a better mom.
Pick a better mom.
This mom's just gonna get you drunk and play you tons of Fallout Boy.
And not feed you.
And not feed
and completely
you.
Forget about you.
No.
I would be the mom that left the baby in the car because I would forget.
At least not on the car, because I've heard that one too.
On the car?
Yeah, the car seat. Oh, yeah, God. Yeah. There was a woman I read about, like, drove all the way down the street with her baby on the roof of the car. Nothing happened to the baby.
Right.
The baby did not come out. I wouldn't tell the story if something happened to the baby.
Oh, God, yeah.
But no, she was like, oh, fuck, you know? Mm-hmm. And I'm like, nope, you fail.
That sounds like something I would probably do.
Total mom fail.
Total mom fail. And I would be an absolute mom fail.
Mm-hmm.
I'm, no.
Could you picture me being a dad?
Oh, God, no.
I mean, I've dated women who've had kids, you know, so I've been around them, but they weren't mine, and I got to go home after.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, you know? I can't imagine you doing the, like, the 2 a.m. diaper changes.
Fuck,
and, like,
no.
You know, the...
Change it yourself.
And, you know, you know? Cleaning up the puke.
I can't do...
And the 1 a.m. emergency room trips.
Oh,
and
God.
All that shit.
I don't have the patience for that shit. God bless you if you're a parent
God
and you can do
you
it.
God bless you if you're a parent.
But some of us are just not parent
material. We are not cut out for parenting.
Yeah.
At all.
I mean, if it was somebody who had older kids, like adolescents,
yeah.
I can deal with
yeah,
that.
Yeah,
but
no.
It's the baby stuff and the little kid stuff that I have
no.
trouble with
I mean,
sometimes.
I dated a guy who had kids.
Mm-hmm.
And his kids are fantastic. And I love them dearly. But they were already trained to, like, dress themselves,
mm-hmm.
feed themselves.
You didn't have to do the hard stuff.
I didn't have to do the hard stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So I just was able to come along and make friends with them.
Right.
And that's all I had to do.
Yeah, I can totally handle that.
And they still love me.
Doesn't everybody?
Of course you do.
The lovable Michelle Poitras. And finally this week...
Hashtag against your will.
I love assault. Mm-hmm. I did... This one... I can't. I just broke myself.
Oh, Lord. Do you need me to read it?
No, I'll do it.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Drunk, torched peanut bag, and made love to ambulance. I can't.
Made love to an ambulance.
Yeah, fuck the peanut bag. How do you fuck?
How do you fuck an ambulance? I guess up the tailpipe.
But why?
Wouldn't you burn your cock? Wouldn't that get hot? Like, really
yeah,
hot?
Yeah, a little bit.
You're not going to understand
hashtag
this,
burnt
but
cock.
That's going to be hot.
Uh-huh.
I don't know. How do you... Do you just, like,
drive no, up fuck how?
Like,
fuck how? Why?
I want to know how.
No, I want to know why.
Because he was drunk.
Neither one of us put together have ever been that drunk to fuck a vehicle.
Probably not.
Maybe probably. If you've ever looked at a car sideways, get out my house.
No. No. No.
But, oh my God.
I still kind of want the logistics of this.
I don't think I do.
I kind of do.
I
kind of
don't.
Need to know this.
No.
Well, but yeah, why wouldn't you burn the ambulance and fuck the peanut bag? That seems way more doable.
What?
If you're going to burn one and fuck the other, why would you just fuck the peanut bag? That seems way more doable. Jay Muse does it all the time.
I'm broken. That's it. You know, that's it. I'm done. That was so fucked up.
No,
I can't even.
Jay Muse said at a... At
what, that he fucked a peanut bag?
No, that he jerks off in his Ziploc bags.
I missed that one.
Yeah, you weren't there. This was Rock and Shock a couple years ago. You couldn't go, and Jay Muse
yeah,
and,
but there
and
isn't,
Brian O'Halloran were there.
There isn't much sexual that man hasn't done.
No, yeah, no, when he said when he jerks off, he'll sometimes use a plastic bag to, like...
Catch it?
Catch the mess, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I wonder if his wife knows that.
Probably. He said it at an appearance at a con. I'm pretty sure his wife knows.
I suppose. God bless that
woman.
She's
probably watched him do it.
I can't... She bore his spawn.
I know. God bless that woman.
Yeah. Holy shit.
I can't imagine what it must be like to be married to him.
Yeah. Well, I mean, he's... He's over 5 years sober, so it's not like she's dealing with the drugs thing.
No, but still, just Jay Muse.
He is an odd duck. There's a reason that Kevin Smith and all of those guys call him Hurricane Muse.
Uh-huh.
But,
we're so off topic right now.
I know. That wasn't even a Twitter tangent. It was just an ADD moment.
Just ADD moment.
So we're going to get the show back on track, and another thing we like to talk about is just general stupidity. You know, nothing specific, just stupid people.
Stupid people everywhere. Stupid people got stupid hair. Stupid people, they don't care. Cause they're stupid, 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 stupid.
Michelle.
Mm-hmm.
People are fucked up. People are idiots.
You think I don't know that? Why do you think I live alone in seclusion?
In this tiny little town. Mm. And just leave me the fuck alone.
Just
because
leave
there,
me the fuck alone.
There is some stupid.
Oh my God.
There is lots of it.
Mm-hmm.
And this. Oh yeah. So this person says, I have been asked to fulfill the following request by customers in the restaurant I work at. I need you to change your carpets. The pattern makes me feel like I don't want to eat anymore, which is a waste of your time.
The logic is sound.
No, it's not. Show me a carpet that makes you not want to eat. carpet. 11 and a half.
All right. So when I was looking to get married, before we eloped.
I was just going to say, to the person you were actually, did you actually marry?
Yes, when we were trying to plan the wedding, before we decided to elope, I was looking at the Westford Regency for the reception.
Mm-hmm.
The carpets in that reception hall were so butt ugly, I said I couldn't, as nice as the location was, the carpets were so butt ugly, I'm like, I can't have my wedding reception in here.
Wow, that's some ugly carpet.
Yeah.
That's like scare the dark out of a closet ugly.
Yeah, they were weird, like orange green, like interlocking octagonal weird, like I can't even describe it, but it was like seizure inducing.
Wow.
So yeah, there are carpets
that will ruin your appetite.
That will ruin your appetite and ruin your mood and ruin your day.
Well, this person goes on. Another request was, my 14-year-old has a toothache. Can he have a shot of vodka?
No.
No, they can't. That would be illegal.
That's illegal.
Yeah, no.
Do what you want in your own home. Swab, you know, Jack Daniels on your baby's gums at home.
Yeah.
That's super old school.
Oh, I know it is. I'm pretty sure I got the brandy on the gums or something like that when I was a kid.
Yeah, I think my nephew might have too.
Yeah. There have been a couple of kids where I wanted to give them booze just because stop.
Yeah, he had the toothaches. My sister did the whiskey on the gums. And all of a sudden he was like...
Yeah, no shit.
And but then he started reaching for the bottle, and Nicole's like, "No, you don't get that bottle. No.
Oh yeah, that was like the thing in my family growing. I was just like, "What? The kid's allowed? Give him a beer. Give him a beer."
I kind of want a beer.
I have some. Oh, and the final request that this person said was, "Can you please play this CD in your sound system? It's my boyfriend singing. There are only two really dirty songs on it, so you can just skip."
No.
No, we can't.
No.
You twit.
No. That's too twitty for Twitter.
I like that. Hashtag too twitty for Twitter. I like that one.
Mm-hmm.
So.
You don't even deserve to be allowed on Twitter. That's bad. And you,
no twit for you.
No twit for you.
Oh my
God. That's how bad you are.
We got a stupid criminal story. Those are always fun.
I love stupid criminal
stories. Oh, yeah. That's an endless wellspring. We could just do stupid criminal stories if that's what we wanted to do.
If that's what we wanted to do.
But this one, a convict broke out of jail in Washington, D.C., and then a few days later accompanied his girlfriend to her trial for robbery. Okay, so he's already on the run, and he goes to a courthouse.
If you could see how hard I'm facepalming right now...
I'd facepalm me so hard. At lunch, he went out for a sandwich. She needed to see him and thus had him paged. Police officers recognized his name and arrested him. I'm not done. As he returned to the courthouse in a car he had stolen over the lunch hour. Get off my planet.
Oh my God, stop! Stop with the crime and the stupid and the things. Stop!
That's just it, dude. If you're going to break the law, make sure you're not a complete fuckwit.
I don't know. I think it takes a special kind of stupid to break the law in the first place.
Yeah, but come on. You broke out of jail, went to a courthouse, went to lunch, stole a car, came back to the courthouse. How delusional and or idiotic do you have to be?
Uh-huh.
He deserves it. He deserves whatever's coming
whatever
to him.
Whatever he gets, he deserves it.
Because fuck you.
Pineapple sideways up the butt, you deserve it.
You're schnirious. That was a little Nicky reference.
It was.
Yes, nice. I actually used the schnirious thing. I stole that.
Sideways.
I stole that when I did a review on my Grindhouse Guy show of a Nazi-sploitation film, and there was this big reveal at the end that this like commander of this neo-Nazi group was actually Hitler. And I just went, Hitler? Are you schnirious? And then I cut to Hitler in Inglourious Basterds just pounding on the table going, 99999!
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yes.
Here's another one. Stupid criminal.
Okay.
When two service station attendants in Ionia, Michigan refused to hand over the cash to an intoxicated robber, the man threatened to call the police.
Go ahead! I want to hear this phone call.
Yeah. They still refused, so the robber called the police, and surprise, folks, he was arrested.
This reminds me of a comedian Bob Marley, not the musician Bob Marley.
Right.
Main comedian Bob Marley, mm-hmm. who's hilarious.
Yes, he is.
talking about going into McDonald's drunk late at night and wanting to go in the play place. But of course, he and his friends are all adults, so they go in the play place. And the poor kid that's stuck working there at like 1 a.m. is like, "You have to get out of there!" And they're like, "Fuck you! Get out of there! I'm gonna call the police." Oh, I want to hear this fucking call. You want me to dial for you?
You're two drunks in the ball pit.
The next morning was the best. All of a sudden, I hear my mother, "Get over here, Harold. The goddamn hamburger thief from the McDonald's is in our yard."
I love your Maine accent. It's fucking... Oh, my God. That's like dead on balls accurate for Maine accent.
Not
it's
really.
Pretty good. It was a little too Lois Griffin, but you know.
Well.
But you do that voice very
Maine,
well.
Connecticut, whatever.
Yeah, whatever, Lois.
Shut up, Peter.
Oh, come on. I do not sound that much like Peter Griffin.
Yes, you do.
My wife did kiss.
And Jake asked.
What?
Nothing. Love you.
And the final stupidity this week. I don't think I can say this person's name. Swedish business consultant Ulf Aftrolle.
Ulf Aftrolle.
Yeah, excuse the shit out of me. Labored 13 years on a book about Swedish economic solutions. He took the 250-page manuscript to be copied, only to have it reduced to 50,000 strips of paper in seconds when a worker confused the copier with the shredder. 13 years.
Of research.
Gone.
Oh my God.
I'm presuming this was his only copy.
Oh,
not
my
something
God.
He could just print out another one.
Did anyone ever see PCU?
A long time ago.
When he trips over the cord and knocks out everybody's theses?
Yes. I do remember that part.
That similar feeling, only like times about 5, because this is 13 years of work instead of like 3.
There's no wrong way to write a thesis. Damn it. I took a chance on that one.
You really did.
I think I rehashed the joke from the accidental poop segment when there was something about like the kid like fed their mom or whatever poop and they didn't realize it was poop. Mm-hmm. And I said, "There's no wrong way to eat a feces."
Yeah, you said that to me before.
I think so. Yeah. All right. I took a chance on that one. Crickets, whatever.
Yeah.
Another thing we like to talk about on this show is sexual situations gone awry, or just fucked up weird situations, or just horrible, horrible, bad, bad, bad sex.
I just had sex and it was so bad. I'm glad that it's over, 'cause the bad sex was so bad. Yeah, I just had bad sex.
This is one I can't believe is a thing.
Okay.
But I'll buy it. And there's a certain fan of ours from Down Under.
Yes!
Who'll appreciate this one.
Okay.
Because it involves stingy, bitey nature land.
Hit me.
An Australian woman was masturbating to some porn when she shot her vibrating Roo, Australia's version of the rabbit. You know the rabbit.
Yeah, and Roo is short for kangaroo.
Right, of course. She shot her Roo clean out of her vagina with a powerful orgasm. The toy bounced off the floor and ricocheted out the window into oncoming traffic. She then leaned out the window to try and find it and wound up falling out of her home and onto the road, ass up, with a grin on her face. Oddly enough, her precious Roo was recovered and, as she puts it, can still hop with the best of them.
But it was outside on the ground! Why would you use it again?
You can wash it off.
Just get a new one! I'm sorry, that's nasty!
Just wash it off!
No!
If it's anything like the rabbit's fucking expensive. This is like a $100 vibrator or some
care.
Shit.
Well, first of all, I'm not that into toys anyway. But second of all, I don't care. If it's been outside on the ground, no amount of washing is going to make me okay with putting it back in there.
It's not like it fell in dog poop or something.
No, but it's fallen on things that have probably touched animal poop.
Yeah, I guess.
And animal pee and all that crap. No way. Outside on the ground, gone. No.
Wow. But, our Australian fan out there, you need to message us.
Stingy, bitey, nature land.
Yes, you need to tell us if this Roo thing is, like, a real thing.
Tell us if this is a real thing,
you don't
please.
Have to admit it if you have one. I just want to know if it exists.
Just tell us, tell us that much.
Yeah. So this next one, another international one. One night last September, a South African couple decided to do it on the train tracks. This is not going to end well.
Nope.
Sadly, their love turned into a train wreck. Despite the conductor's cries and, a giant, noisy freight train headed straight for them, he couldn't get their attention and were both killed. Listen up, kids. This is just another reason not to play on the railroad tracks.
I don't
fuck on the railroad tracks.
No.
And finally this week, the things that people do to their bodies, the things that people will put in their intimate places, never ceases to amaze me. A man decided to surprise his love with a flower, stuck in his penis.
Oh, no!
He plucked a geranium from the garden and inserted the stem in his pee hole. Unfortunately, oh God, I'm crossing my legs before I even read this. Unfortunately, the hairy fibers on the stem tore his urethra to shreds, and he needed to have surgery. Hopefully next time he'll just use a vase.
Yeah, no.
Don't put things in your dick.
No.
It's not built for that.
Nope.
Things are meant to come out of it, not go into it.
No. Nothing in the pee hole.
No.
Nothing goes in the pee hole.
Especially things with fucking hairy fibers and, yeah. Oh, God. That was just painful to even read. So I think on that note, we're going to wrap it up for this week. Thank you, everybody, for joining us.
Yeah.
Guys, have fun with that one. Thank you for joining us. If you're new to the podcast, join the Facebook group. Find us on SoundCloud, YouTube, and on Twitter at
TIWTADC.
The Mr. Q, Michelle Poitras.
Yeah, sorry. I was on Twitter.
Another reason the aliens don't come.
Seriously.
This podcast is the property of Brendan Millett, all rights reserved. All music and audio clips used in this podcast are the property of their respective copyright owners. This podcast was hosted by Brendan Millett and Michelle Poitras. Opening theme composed and performed by Chris Lott. Official logo by Michael Magario at Pixel Pusher Studio. If you've enjoyed this podcast, join our Facebook group at facebook.com/groups/thisiswhythealiensdon'tcome, all one word.